So my lawsuit does not, contrary to the opinion of Nigger Mania, smell like a nigger. So Kelly Ayotte was not proper to throw my nigger ass out.
Hey Kelly, do you accept the support from Nigger Mania or not? Do you accept the online support you're getting from Nigger Mania or not? That's not yes or no question.
Mr. Holman, do you think Kelly Ayotte is a racist?
You know what? I know she is. I had the assistance of Congressman Inslee from Washington because I had just moved from Seattle.
Yes.
And he was on my side and he was fighting. And I sent him an email and said, Congressman, with all your help and everything we've done, I guess we're in a, something's not happening the way it should because my son's in a coma. My ROIA request was completely just, they sent me one cover page from a fax and that was it, and there was nothing on it. So she told
me. Let's back up a minute. You had a public information request, and sure. You know that it involved, I think I documented this on my journal. Yeah. You had a public information request that encompassed several months of investigation, and you got one page.
They expunged it all. I believe she was trying to cover up. She was running for Senate. She tried to cover up everything. You know, my son almost died. He was in a coma due to physical neglect. When I showed up for court hearings, I was falsely arrested. And the chief of police had a lot to do with it.
What's his name?
John Pickering.
From where?
Ex-chief of police in Madison. He used to be a colonel of the state police of New Hampshire. It was basically, they were jealous. I bought a big, beautiful home, a ski chalet up in Madison, New Hampshire. I believe they were jealous. He was in my home. He covered for crimes by the mother's other white children. And
let's stop right there. I understand that the white children, the first children born by the mother of your children, are in deep criminal trouble right now. I understand one of them is up on charges of attempted murder. Is that correct?
No, he's serving 4 years in federal.
Oh, convicted?
Yeah, convicted. I think they dropped it to assault, too. But
these are the people
dangerous children that I feel, you know, my sons told me that they were harmed by these people.
And sexual abuse, is that correct?
Yeah, unfortunately.
And when you complain about that...
I understand children can experiment and so forth, but the mother deliberately tried to cover these things up, deliberately lied. There's so much perjury in the case, and we got to a point where Anne Rice and Michael Delaney supposedly are investigating these things, but it's too late, too little. It's already, we know the feds are supposedly investigating, so. And her mom came to me in tears, and so, you know, if you like her, take her with you. Get her out of here.
And you just started dating.
And I decided, you know, her mom was in tears. And Wendy seemed like she was really a nice person. But once I got involved with her, boy, she turned into a monster.
When did the drugs come out?
You know, you couldn't tell that they were drug addicts. Her or her friends, you couldn't tell that they were drug addicts. And, but her friends kept saying, oh, you love her, she's great, you should hang out with her. You gotta spend time with her if you want her to like you, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, why don't you do that? At my age, I decided to do it.
And so you had three children?
Ended up being three.
When did you find out that drugs
may have... I loved having kids.
Well, I'm sure you did.
When did you find out that the drugs might be in your, that your children may have been born with drugs?
She would always say that, you know, no, she was getting help, she wasn't doing it anymore. And, you know, you just take her word for it.
What kind of drugs was she doing?
She was doing crack. She did crack. She was drinking vodka. But she wouldn't do it in front of me. I was a working man, so I'd leave and go off to work. Well, not like she'd be passed out on the couch or anything. You just, dude.
So let me ask you this.
The only way I'd find out, sometimes she would be going through withdrawals, and her sister would be there holding her, and I'd be like, what the fuck is she going through?
Right.
And they're like, why are you asking? And she would be like, you're just a dumbass. What are you wearing? I mean,
for shrimp.
Thank you, Joelle.
You're welcome.
Well, that is a rumored nightmare.
Wow.
No, it's definitely.
So at some point, though, she neglected at least one of your children, and your child was involved in an accident?
Yeah.
What happened there?
Oh, she just left them out to run in the street with no shoes, no helmet. He rode his bike and was in an accident and left in a coma, and they rushed him to the hospital. He was in a coma for, I don't know, 7 or 10 days or something like that. But he survived.
And you complained to the New Hampshire authorities, did you not?
Oh, repeat. I called every one of them. I faxed. I'd get up at 5 in the morning typing letters to fax to them. And they would always just come back and say, no, the chief police didn't do anything wrong. No, nobody did anything wrong. They were all lying.
And where were you living at the time?
At what time?
Well, that's a complex question. Where were you living at the time that
when was harmed?
Yes, when your son was harmed.
I was still fighting my battle. I was in the state of California.
And you were working as a yacht builder?
Yes, I am a yacht repair company, but I had the assistance of Congressman Inslee from Washington, because I had just moved from Seattle.
Yes.
And he was on my side, and he was fighting. And I sent him an email and said, Congressman, with all your help and everything we've done, I guess we're in a... Something's not happening the way it should, because my son's in a coma.
And you had complained before then, though. You had warned them before then, right?
5 days before that accident, I emailed the Connecticut DCF, and I said, my children are in danger. And I don't believe they did anything, because New Hampshire had already told Connecticut that this is the way we're going to do it. Mr. Holmes is a black man, blah, blah, blah. And they didn't help me.
Well, these are the dangers of, or some will say, these are the perils of dating a white woman in New Hampshire. What do you think about that?
You know, I would definitely. New Hampshire, I bought a beautiful house in the hills in New Hampshire, a ski chalet. And they didn't like it, and I guess this was their way of letting me know that they didn't like it. I think they slept with Wendy. I think they did anything and everything. And they led her to do everything that she did.
Mr. Holman, I understand that you've made several allegations of unlawful discrimination in New Hampshire with respect to the white mother of your children who has neglected them.
Yes. Numerous. More time than I care to count.
And has anyone from New Hampshire ever helped you with that?
No.
But what about Congressman Inslee? Tell me about that.
It's Congressman Inslee from Washington. Congressman Inslee was the first to stand up and say, your children were stolen from my state. They were returned to a dangerous, dreadful household. Bring me all of your evidence, and I'm going to take this to the FBI, my liaison. He was the first to step forward and take up my case. Thankfully, that gave me a lot of power, a lot of strength to believe that someone actually cared. It was outside of New England before anyone did anything. New Hampshire tried to cover it all up. Kelly just refused to do anything. Tom P. Colantuno refused to do anything. Judge Albee refused to do anything. She covered. And they actually forced my two attorneys, Jennifer Haskell and Stanley Hawthorne, to withdraw. So it was basically a fraud and conspiracy. They said, oh, break down in communication. I'm not a loud person. I don't argue. I use facts. And literally, it was fraud and conspiracy. And I feel like the Department of Justice had to do something. Thankfully, the United States Commission on Civil Rights went to the Department of Justice and said, we're going to ask you to do an investigation on Mr. Holman's behalf. And hopefully that continues. I do have evidence that an FBI investigation is continuing.
Indeed. Thank you, sir.